Good morning. I just wanted to say welcome to family and friends of Christopher. We were able to meet with Linda and Luann just this past week and just to get to know them and hear about their relationship and also just a little bit about Christopher. And today is just a day of celebration, right? Right there. Celebration of life. So from birth to now, whatever you've experienced with him, really right now we celebrate because we know where he's at, right? Everyone's life has up and down journeys, right? And we just say, Lord, in the end, just help me to be with you and let it be right, right? So today we're just going to celebrate where he's at, celebrate his life. And I encourage you, if you have anything to share later on, there is that moment of sharing there in the program. Anyone's welcome to share. You don't have to come up here to share. You can sit, you can stand from where you're at. This is a very wonderful, intimate group. So you can do that and not feel worried about where you're going to share, what you're going to share. You're surrounded by your friends and family. So with that, I'd like to just open this up in a word of prayer. And then we do know that Christopher requested to hear the song, How Great Thou Art. So after that, we're going to have a video of him. Pictures of Christopher, along with that song playing in the background. And the other thing that he requested is that his friend, sister and colleague, Dr. Maxine, share a song today. So just to prepare your hearts, we'll have a word of prayer. And again, thank you all for coming today. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you, Lord, that we're able to come together today, family, friends, close, not so close. Lord, we just thank you that we're able to come and support Linda and her family and just to give you the glory. Lord, right now, as emotions are maybe tired, bodies are tired, Lord, we just ask that you can help everyone to take a breath and just to celebrate your creation, your son. And we thank you again that he's with you today. We just ask that you be in this time. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. share, I would want to leave that little cushion there. So if you want to share something other than the red scooter, or you want to comment on the same red scooter, that's fine, because that's how you knew Chris. And again, I just want to go back away. And if anyone else wants to stand up where you're at, you can sit down even and just share. Okay, thank you for sharing.
Hi, my name is Corey. I'd just like to say Chris is the kind of friend that you'd like to have as a friend. My car broke down, so I had tire, gas. I was in his home, came to pick me up. Anything, he was always there for me. You know, helping out, just like he volunteered here. You know, he was just that kind of person. That's all I was going to say.
Thank you.
Services office. I know Dr. Maxine is going to share some soon. I was just chatting with Dr. Maxine and Joyce in the family services office. She just remembered going, oh yeah, he was a worker bee. So they would actually have to pause every once in a while and go, are you okay? Are you okay? Because he's moving things around and sweating all around. And they said, you know, that he was a volunteer type of a heart that was like, I'm going to go gung ho. And so even just to know that part of his life is a real encouragement to know that he was there as a neighbor, that you know him as a good friend. And I think you said he even gave clothes off of that. So I just want to say I'm glad that you guys were able to share that. Again, there's going to be more fellowship time after, so you guys can continue to share about Christopher. But in this time, we'll just ask Dr. Maxine to come and share.
Before I sing, I would just like to give honor to Linda and to all of you, his family and friends. Yes, I did know Chris pretty well from the family services area. And Chris would come in, and I'm going to tell you, Chris would have been, he would go into the hospital and have different procedures. When he got well, he would come back and he'd say, I'm here to help, what do you want me to do? And so we said, hey, Chris, and at that time, we had another brother by the name of Ronnie, who worked with Chris, and they were just a great team. In these days, young people, our younger generation, really sometimes struggle with knowing how to really work. I'm going to tell you, Chris, and as Captain has said, Chris would get in there and he would just take care of whatever needed to be done. And so we always appreciated that Chris did not have a lazy bone in his body. He would get it done. The other thing that we appreciated is that Chris cared about his immortal soul. Chris cared about a relationship, his own personal relationship with Jesus Christ, and getting his heart and things right in his life. He cared about that. And he would come into my office and we would have conversations on the things that really mattered to him, things that he was thinking about. And he also met with some of the other officers, our former officers as well, who talked about spiritual matters and other issues that were laying on his heart. So this was a man that I encountered who wanted to live out. He knew that the doctor said he only had a certain amount of time, but he wanted to give that time that he had his health and strength to serve the Lord. And that was a message to me, and it was a message to everybody else, that all of us, there's a time clock that's ticking on each one of our lives. And his way of serving was serving people. His way of serving was serving in our family services when he had the help and the strength to do that. So it's an honor for me to have gotten to know him towards the last part of his life. And now to honor him with this song, it is my delight. And it's called I Cry and Holy.
Thank you. Thank you for introducing me to the Father God and Brother Jesus. I remember that's the greatest two gifts that can be given. Connie, thank you for my beautiful niece and nephew, which... gave me a beautiful great niece and nephew. Luann, I thank you for always being there growing up. I remember it like yesterday. No matter what, every Wednesday night and Saturday we were sitting yelling. Especially when Travis was up yelling out Chris. There are so many more things I can recall. All of them, Brother Bruce, Brother Norman, thank you for taking care of my sisters. Then to Jennifer, thank you for my beautiful daughter, Alyssa Marie. And to Alyssa Marie, I love you more. You will always
let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, thank you for gathering us today to remember the precious life of Chris Thompson. We also gather to say goodbye one last time and celebrate the life that he enjoyed here on earth, and thank you for each precious moment and memory that we, the family and friends, have had with him. His life has touched so many people in different ways. We pray that your peace and presence will be upon his family and friends. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, I can't imagine what some of you are going through right now. Linda, I can't even fathom losing my child. Alyssa, your dad. Okay. Imagine what you all are going through. Your brother. I can't, but our Lord Jesus can. He knows exactly what you're going through. When Jesus was here on earth, he experienced loss too, and the Bible says that he wept. God has made us so we have a relationship with one another, and that when that relationship is lost, we feel pain. You have lost a loved one, and it hurts. So today I would like to speak a word of comfort to you all. It comes from John chapter 14, verses 1 through 6. And this is our Lord Jesus speaking. And he says, "Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God and believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. For I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way I am going." And then Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How do we know the way? Then Jesus said to them, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but through me. And that also echoes what Dr. Maxine sang about mansions in heaven, from mansions to mansions, looking for Jesus in that song. Well, from this passage of scripture, we find three thoughts of comfort. The first thought of comfort is that peace is promised. Notice the words, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. Today is a day of sadness as we reflect. It's a day of grief, a day of mourning. And yet in the midst of all of the sadness, there is peace. We can have that peace. Why? Because we have faith. We believe. We believe that in the midst of the storm, even in the valley of the shadow of death, there can be peace that passes all understanding. Because we know that God is with us. Amen? Psalm 23 says, yeah, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. God is here. God is present. Believe in him, trust God, and he will grant you, all of us, his peace. And Jesus even said in John chapter 14, verse 27, he says, peace I leave with you, my peace I give you, I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid. Again, emphasizing Jesus' peace with us. And as I thought about this, I used to live in Guam. And Guam, we get a lot of typhoons or hurricanes. And I remember many times we have super typhoons, which gust the wind over 200 miles per hour. But whenever the typhoon comes, and then there's the middle of the typhoon, you know, the typhoon in the middle of it, there's a hole. It's a place of peace. And I remember, you know, whenever the typhoon passes, that means you're in the middle. You're in the midst of the storm. And you go outside and everything is calm. Everything is peaceful. And then you have to get back in soon because the other half is coming. And so I just want to share that because in the midst of the storms of life, whatever that we're going through, we can have that peace with the Lord. The eye of the storm. We can be in that peace with Jesus. And having a personal relationship with Jesus enables us to live life with peace in our hearts. And I was wondering about all of us today in this chapel. Do we have that peace that our Lord Jesus was talking about? That peace in our heart. That eye of the storm. To be in the eye of the storm. Do we have that? The good news is that if we just two things. Repent of our sins, say, Lord, forgive me, and believe in Jesus, put our faith and trust in Jesus, and accept him as our Lord, we can have that peace. And I pray that all of us are in that relationship with Jesus. If you're not, today can be that day for you. And today, Chris is at peace with God. The second thought of comfort that is that God has prepared a place for us. Now, in that chapter, John 14, it says, I go to prepare a place for you. Now, the Bible teaches that in 6 days, God created the whole world. And he rested on the seventh day. But just imagine for over 2,000 years, Jesus Christ went to be with the Father, and he said that he's going to be preparing a place for us. He's going to many, many days preparing that place for us, preparing a place for me, preparing preparing a place for you, and Chris is there right now in glory. Jesus Christ has prepared that place for him, and he is experiencing that in glory. And the heaven is beyond our mind. It is beyond our thoughts, and we just trust that what the Bible talks about heaven to be. Now, if you think about the most beautiful waterfall, whatever that waterfall is in your mind, you think about the most beautiful sunset, whatever that beautiful sunset that you have in your mind, maybe somewhere on the coast, whatever that beautiful thing that you can think of, times it by 1,000 or 1,000,000, and you get a glimpse of heaven. Heaven is beyond our comprehension. Heaven is beyond our imagination. And 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9 says, however, it is as it is written, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no mind has conceived what God has prepared for those who love him. It's beyond our imagination. I can just imagine Chris just now in heaven experiencing that glory with Jesus. Chris is literally in a better place compared to earth. Not only that he is in the glory with a new home, but he is with, you know, some of the people that have gone before him in glory. The final thought of comfort is that God has prepared a way for us to get there. Isn't that beautiful? He's there, but God has prepared a way for all of us too. Now, everyone who wants to go to heaven, and some people don't know how to get there, but Jesus tells us in John 14:6, he says, this is the key. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but by me. We are all traveling on this road called life. There are many detours and side streets. We don't have to be confused or lost. We can trust in Jesus, and he can lead us home. Now, my wife and I went to Israel, 2016, and in Israel we have a tour guide, and we have this thing in our ear, and so we're with a crowd, with our group, and the tour guide is explaining a bunch of things, and so sometimes I kind of walk off doing my own thing, and then the reception is, you know, diminishing, so I have to come back to the group and listening, and then we get on the tour bus, and then we keep on listening to the tour guide. And you know what? That is kind of like the picture of this life. I have confidence in the tour guide. I have never been to Israel. I have confidence in the bus driver. All I have to do is trust them. All I have to do is to listen to them and to be closer to them. That's all I have to do. And I can go from point A to point B and back. And I think that's what Jesus meant when he says, he is the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but through me. Just stay close to Jesus, and Jesus will lead us to glory. Now, it's nice to hear about Chris. I did not know him. You know, I've never met him, but it's nice to hear about him, that he knew the Lord, knew Jesus. And it's a wonderful thing, because he is in glory with Jesus. And Chris would want all of us to say yes to Jesus. Now that he is in glory, if he can say something to us right now, I'm sure that he would say, trust in Jesus. I'm waiting for you. He took an earlier train. But you know what? The train is coming through for us. The question is the destination of where the train goes. If we put our trust in Jesus, when the train comes, we can be with Christ again in glory. And that is a wonderful promise. So I just want to encourage you with these words, that Christ is in glory, and He would want us to, we will see Him again. Amen?
Yeah.
You will see Him again because we trust in Jesus. Jesus is the key. So let us remember Christ's legacy. Let us continue to lift up the family and his friends in prayer. Let us rejoice that Christ is with Jesus in glory. And just to remember that one day, if we decide, if we put our trust in Jesus, we too can be with Christ. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word. Lord, that Christ is with you in glory, that he is probably walking the streets of gold. The glimpse of heaven that we read in Revelation. Father, we thank you for that. We thank you for Christ's life and with you in glory. And Lord, help us here, especially the family, Lord, his family. Give them peace continually in their hearts. And that confidence, Lord, that one day they too will see Christ again. So, Father, be with all of us here. Bless our time together and in our fellowship. Lord, we just praise you for who you are. Again, Lord, we lift up Linda, Alyssa, and the whole family up to you. Continue to comfort them. We thank you and we'll commit them into your hand. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thou art, when shall come with shouts of acclamation and take me home. What joy shall fill my heart? Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou art, how